Welcome back to the story of liberty. Alfred the Great was born in England in the year 851. He defeated the cruel Vikings and united and saved England from these people that raped and pillaged everywhere they went. He did that around common law in the Ten Commandments. He personally fought 54 hand-to-hand battles. Alfred the Great, the Christian. He's the only English king to be accorded with the epithet, the Great. Alfred was a brilliant and merciful man who encouraged Christian education. And he improved England's legal system through proper and just laws that were taken from Holy Scripture. Much of the law code of England was taken from the book of Exodus and the apostolic letter to the Acts of the Apostles. That's what he did. Alfred meditated on Christian law and scripture. He realized that he needed to issue God's higher law to the people of England. The link between the Mosaic law and Alfred's code is the apostolic letter, which explained that Christ had not come to shatter or annul the commandments, but to fulfill them. He taught mercy and meekness. Alfred's own personal transformation was of Christ's commandment from love your neighbor as yourself. Alfred was a great warrior. He won decisive victories in many battles. But Alfred, instead of killing his enemies, he converted them to Christianity. That was never done during this time. 3 weeks after he converted, the Viking king had a big ceremony. 29 of his chief men and Guthrum, the Viking king, were baptized at Alfred's court, and Alfred received him as his spiritual son. He established Christian schools for the education of his own children and many other children. They studied books in English and in Latin and devoted themselves to writing. He recruited scholars from the continent and from Britain to aid in the revival of Christian learning. Alfred's strong educational belief was that without the Christian religion, without Christian teaching and learning, there was no true wisdom to be found. There could be neither prosperity or success in this life. Alfred transformed England. Alfred proposed the primary education be taught in English, and the problem, however, was that there were few books of wisdom written in English. Most were in Latin. Alfred sought a remedy to this problem. He translated into English the books that were deemed most necessary. The Bible was most necessary, and it was taught in English to the children of England. Alfred the Great had 6 children. He believed what Genesis 1:28 said about being fruitful and multiplying. He said this, he said, "Give me men who can pray, men who can fight, men who can build, and I will build a lasting civilization." Alfred the Great, the great man of God.